Good day, grade 10s. Welcome to our last lesson in week 20 on Euclidean geometry. And today we're going to be looking at the kite. Now, kite is a very special quadrilateral, especially because it doesn't relate to a rhombus, a parallelogram, a rectangle, or a square. It is a standalone quadrilateral which has its own properties. So let's have a look at what the properties of a kite. So the definition of a kite is it's a quadrilateral with two pairs of adjacent sides that are equal. In other words, what it's saying is that AC is equal to AD and DB is equal to BC. Let's look at all the other properties of a kite. First of all, it states the diagonals between the equal sides bisect each other. In other words, if you look at this side here and that side there, those two are equal sides. And what it is saying is that the diagonals bisect each other. So in other words, this diagonal is equal to this diagonal. Then, it also says that one pair of opposite angles are equal. So it's these two. The angle C is equal to angle D. And I'm going to prove that to you in a minute. Next, it says the diagonals between each equal sides bisect the interior angles and is the axis symmetry. So again, what it's saying is that this diagonal is the axis symmetry and that angle there equals this angle here and this angle here equals this angle here. Right, and again, I'm going to be proving that to you in a second. And then finally, that the diagonals bisect each other at 90 degrees. Right, so let's look at some proofs. So in this proof, what we're going to do is prove that angle ADB, ADB, and equals angle ACB, So we're going to prove that this angle equals that angle. And then we're going to prove the diagonals bisect each other. So notice we're going to prove that this angle equals that angle, and that angle equals that angle. And we're going to do it in one fell swoop. We're going to prove that this triangle, ABD, is congruent to triangle ABC. So let's have a look at that. So if we look at triangle ABD and triangle ABC, do we agree that we know that AB equals AB because it's common? Right? We also know that AC equals AD. Why? Because it is the basic properties of a kite. In order for this to be a kite, this side has to be equal to this side. So we can use that. So we know that AD is equal to AC. Why? Because it's a property of a kite. And similarly, since this is a kite, we know that DB has to equal BC. That DB has to equal BC. Again, because it's a property of a kite. Therefore, we've proven that triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ABC. Why? Because of side. But if that's the case, if this triangle here is congruent to this triangle, then it means that this angle must equal that angle. Okay, if we look at it, if we follow it round from DAB, if we look at angle DAB, okay, then if we follow it around the same way, we've got BAC is equal to angle BAC, proved above, okay. Also, because this triangle is congruent to this triangle, we know that this angle here must equal that angle there. If we follow it around, we've got ABD. So we've got angle ABD is equal to angle ABC, And finally, because those two are equal to each other and also because of congruency, it is pretty obvious that angle C has to equal angle D. So there we've proven not only that the diagonals bisect A and B, therefore the diagonals bisect A, angle A and angle B, oopsie, sorry. Also, we've proven that angle C is equal to angle D. Not too bad for one set of congruency, hey? Let's look at the next bit. Here we're going to have, see the proof that the diagonals bisect at 90 degrees. Diagonals bisect at 90 degrees. So we're trying to prove this. So if we look at that, if we use this triangle and this triangle, it's not going to help me at all, okay? But I could look at this little triangle here, and I'm going to call this O. O. So I could look at triangle ACO, and I could look at triangle ADO. And if I prove that these two are congruent, then it would mean that these two angles are equal, and since they're equal, they're supplementary. And therefore, they would add up to 90 degrees. We could do exactly the same thing with this triangle and this triangle, but I've decided to do the top two. So if we look at this, if we're looking at in triangle ACO and triangle ADO, we can see that AC has to be equal to AD. Why? Because it's the property of a kite. Okay. We also know that this side here, AO, equals AO because it's common. Okay. We also know, because we've proven it already, but it is a property of kite, that this angle equals that angle. So therefore we can say that CAO, angle CAO, is equal to angle DAO. And you can either say a property of a kite, or if you were doing this in the exams, you could have said, okay, we proved it above. We proved it in the previous proof that we did. So we proved above. Therefore, we have that triangle is ACO is congruent to triangle ADO. And how do I know this? Because I've got a side and a side, an angle and an angle and a side. So I've got a side, an enclosed angle and a side. A side, an enclosed angle and a side. So we've got side, angle, side. Right, that's awesome, because then we can say that angle AOC is equal to angle AOD, why? Because it's proved above. Okay, proved above. But angle AOC plus angle AOD equal to 180 degrees. Why? Because they are supplementary, because they are on a straight line. Therefore, angle AOC equals angle AOD, which equals 90 degrees. Awesome. So now we've just proven that that angle there and that angle there are 90 degrees, and obviously then if that's 90 degrees, then that has to be 90 degrees, and that has to be 90 degrees. So I've proven that they cut at 90 degrees, but I haven't proven that this, I haven't said yet, I haven't shown that that side there is equal to that side there. But that comes from the fact that these two triangles are congruent. We also know that side CO is equal in length to side DO. Why? Because it is proved above, because triangle ACO is congruent to triangle ADO. So grade 10s, be careful when you're doing these proofs that you don't just prove that it crosses at 90 degrees and not prove that it bisects, or that you prove that it bisects and not that it crosses 90 degrees. It's all the same proof, you just need to state it. So therefore we've just said that this side here, I'm going to make it three little stripes, is equal to this side here. Why? Because this triangle is congruent to this triangle. Right, and that's it, grade 10 for kites and for Euclidean geometry for the minute. Please go learn all your properties. Make sure you can use them. Make sure you can prove them using your congruency. Have a lovely day.